Sepp, Waldhandwerk, together with Tim. Steintanz, we say hello and welcome to you all. Glad that you are here. We make a small virtual bush meeting, bushcraft meeting together. Yeah, for my person I make a short break here. I have no water, so I need water. Make a small fire. I started with small birch twigs and birch bark, but you should not burn too much birch because of the Birkenteer, like asphalt. So don't use too much birch in a cave or under the tent or so on. Yeah, and then I fired with other dead wood I found here in this, we called it moor sumpf area.
Okay, first I'd like to show you the most typical way I start a fire most of the time. I have this little platform, I have some fire starter that you can buy. It's made from natural fibers and some kind of vegetable oil. I only use a very tiny bit of it like this, put it on the platform. Then I also have some resin here, it's usually a dry resin, fire steel. And I also make a little construction like this here, and this helps me. As soon as the tinder is ignited and it burns, I put on the resin, and then when I put on the twigs, the fine twigs, I don't have to throw the twigs directly onto the tinder, but instead I have them up here nice in the flames, and the tinder can burn without any lack of oxygen. Let me just show you.
The birch bark I collected before. Keep something for later. Then I let the fire grow and first fill next wood on it if the fire is higher than the material. Please visit the channel from my friend Tim from Steintanz, what calls the name is Stone Dance in the direct translation to English as Waldhandwerk. Yeah, is Bushcraft. But first we think we all make German videos, and yeah, like it was by me, people say, hey, you just can German, go to my video.de and so on, YouTube is English, and yeah, now I'm glad because I met a lot of you guys all over the world, and for sure more than I would stay in my very southern Austrian German, which also don't understand everyone. Fighting dogs. This part from the dead tree is again good for me as in this form as this holder from my metal cup.
Let's talk about how to find water outside that is safe to drink and to use. First, you want to check that the water is clear, that it's running, and that it's cold. And once these points are clear, there is another quite interesting method that I'd like to share with you. And this method is based on the little organisms in the water, in the sediment or under the rocks. Let's just have a look. So when you turn around some rocks or have a look at the sediments, you will find little organisms like this one here, for example. Another one here. Right? You should always put them back again. Nothing, maybe something here. Nope. It depends a little bit on the temperature. This is a big good one. Pretty big. This one here. Right. Piece of a clam. Also can be a good sign depending on when and how it died, of course. Here as well. Down here. So you should have a look at some rocks. Check around for some time. Of course, also check up and down the stream or the river. It once happened to me that I wanted to take some water from our little creek, and just a few meters upstream there was a dead fox lying right in the water. So this was pretty good that I noticed it before. Well, okay, now let's have a look what you can do once you have identified these organisms. You need something like this. This table shows the organisms that you find in different qualities of water. The first one would be the best quality of water. This is still quite good, moderate. And down here you wouldn't want to use these types of water. And from the organisms that you find, you can see that the long-term quality of the water can be evaluated quite well. For example, we found this one I had just here, another one like this, and one of this. And so this little creek, usually most time of the year, is somewhere between quality very good to good. So usually this water can be used, but still it is necessary to use, for example, something to sterilize the water, something to filter it or boil it, because quality of water does not mean that there are no bacteria in it or nor no egg worms or no viruses. This is something you still have to do. So boil it, filter it, or poison it with sterilization.
For sure, such a small quick fire might be the fastest way to boil, purify, or melt some water. But what I like to say, guys and girl, I have so much fun and joy with your cool Swedish torches, log fires, Canadian candles, and so on. I learned so many things out of this video, some splitting techniques and torches to hold around like a laterne, big torches, burning trees, also fantastic. Yeah, and I full set until the 18th of February, and I burn to make my own Swedish torch out of your great knowledge. So thank you. Ja, Tim, und dir sage ich auch danke. Ich genieße es irrsinnig, deine Videos anzuschauen. Du bist echt eins mit der Natur. Ja, und wer hätte das geglaubt, irgendwie so, ja, nur Internet und so weiter, aber ich empfinde dich echt als Freund. Du weißt, wenn du irgendwas, wenn du Richtung München kommst und du brauchst was, sagst du, ja, ich hol dich. Verstehst du, das ist logisch. Ja. When the water is melted, you can fill in more snow. In the first time you should compress the snow, because of this good isolation you have much air in the snow. But when the water is when the snow is water, you can fill in just in this form snow.
The aquaventure system, or formerly it was known as the aquamira, is a pretty good sterilization system. You have two parts, mix them together, put them in the water after some time, and it kills most of the critical organisms in the water very well. It also kills protists, for example giardia, or some people know it as beaver fever. This is pretty safe to use. Of course, filter systems are even better, but the difficult thing is always to evaluate the quality of water as far as chemicals in the water are concerned. It's really difficult to judge in civilized areas whether the water is poisoned with chemicals or if it's good to drink. Of course, this can change very quickly as soon as somebody puts some illegal chemical substance in the water upstream. You will have it right here. Although the organisms can indicate a pretty good water quality, if somebody drops something up there in the stream, I will have the chemicals here, and I cannot determine this, the short-term effects from the organisms.
Then I might make myself a spruce tea. Many thanks to Josie from Bushcraft Buttons. I always love and like to drink the small, the young spruce sprengling in Frühling. Frühling. Summer, autumn, winter. But I not thought so far that I also can use the spruce twigs from here. So thanks for this lesson too. I let the fresh leaves and twigs and stuff always boiling, cooking 15 minutes, and then sit for another 10 minutes until I drink the tea out of fresh plants. Cheers. Prost, Tim. taste is fantastic. You drink a forest. Imagine, the stuff is... But it's temperatures out here on the open fire. This is tea. Not those tiny dust bags. Yeah, sorry. Also good, but this is first class tea. It gives you warm power, strongness, energy, and make you healthy. So Team, wir machen weiter. Tim is cold with his rubber boots and his umbrella, and if you like to learn abseiling, Tim is the right one, not from me. Yeah, he was on the Yukon. Great guy. So, you see one video from both of us, but we make now fire water, and then the next parts. Yeah, so stay tuned. See you. Bis bald. Sepp von Waldhandwerk für dich. Bye.